So we've been talking about implementation of access control and for resources and, you know, requests for those resources. And we said, well, in Unix-based systems, resources look like files. So let's actually see how those resources are used and, you know, what kind of calls we make for accessing them and what happens during those calls. So first of all, of course, a resource has to be created. Okay, so the process that creates this resource is the owner. That owner can have whatever set of access rights they want to have. In Unix-like system, you probably know there are a number of ways in which you can create a file, for example. So once a file exists and we want to access it, you do what is called open the file. Okay, so this is sort of like prepping the file. If it doesn't exist, then file gets created. When you do that, file has a name, and mode here says, you know, do you want to read this file, or do you want to write it, or, you know, execute it? What are you opening it for? How do you want to access it? You know, once a file exists, the first thing we do is open it. When you open it, the operating system returns you a file descriptor, which is a small number. Okay? And we'll see how what the use of that is. But, you know, as a result, we'll see that to be able to access or get, you know, the data that's in the file or write data into the file, we're going to need the file's descriptor. So the descriptor comes when you open the file, you prep it or get it ready for access. So a system call you make saying, this is the file I want to access, this is how I access it. The operating system prepares the file for access, returns you this descriptor, file descriptor, that you then hold on to. So if you want to read this file in the read call, this is another system call that you have. You have to go to the system. You specify what file using a descriptor. This is what was returned here. Right? It's a small number. So this could be 5, for example. If you're reading, you had to specify where the read data should be put, how much data you're reading. Well, that's the buffer and its size. So data is going to come from the file. Where is this data? Well, file, we know, unless file pointer that points at the next place from where data is going to come, and it's advanced as you read. So whatever data follows the file, current file pointer, we're going to pull that data, place that in the buffer, and that's what the read call is going to do. Similarly, there's a write call, except that the data flows in the opposite direction. So the data is here, and then it's going to go into the file. And how much data, that's what we specify in this call. So, you know, open is followed by one or more read or writes. And when you're done, you close the file, okay? And once you close the file, again, the input here is the descriptor that says what file that you had opened before. Then this file, we are basically telling the system is that we're not going to need to access it anymore. So the system can, you know, if it had set up some data structures, it can essentially free those up at that point. Resource is a file. Users have UID. We also talked about group ID. And to access a resource, this is what basically have to go through. File exists, they have to open it, then they have to say read or write it, and then you close it. If you forget to close it and the process terminates, it's implicitly closed, but this is how a file gets used.